Which number is 75% of 4? Let the number is k. So k equals 75% of 4 is equal to 75% times 4, where 75% equals 75/100. So 75% of 4 equals 75 × 4/100, which results in 3. Therefore, 3 is the number which is 75% of 4. That is, 75% of 4 is 3. 3 is 60% of which number? Let the number is z. Therefore, 3 equals 60% of z, or 3 is equal to 60% times z. As 60% equals 60/100, therefore 3 equals 60/100 times z. Here, 6/10 is the equivalent fraction of 60/100, which helps us to get that 30 equals to 6z. So 6 times z equals 30, which helps us to get the result where z equals 5. Therefore, 3 is 60% of 5. So 3/5 equals 60%, where 5 is the whole and 3 is the part, and 60% denotes that 3 parts out of 5 parts. Fractions where denominator can become 100 will easily be expressed as percents. According to the identity rules of multiplication, we know that the product of any number and 1 is that number. So a/100 is equal to a/100 times 1. 1 equals 100%. Therefore, a/100 times 100% results in a%. So we can easily write that a/100 equals a × 1/100 is equal to a%, where 1/100 is equivalent to percent or 1%. Applying the rules, we can write that 15/100 equals 15 × 1/100, which results in 15%. Similarly, 3/5 equals 60%, where 3/5 is the equivalent fraction of 60/100. Again, 7/10 is the equivalent fraction of 70/100. Therefore, 7/10 equals 70%. And 63/1000 is equal to the equivalent fraction 6.3/100. Therefore, 63/1000 is equal to 6.3%. In general, the whole is called the base or denominator of the percent equivalent, and the part represents the numerator. When the numerator of a percent is greater than the base, the percent is greater than 100%. For example, if we consider 5/2, for which the equivalent fraction with 100 in denominator is 250/100, which is equal to 250 × 1/100, where 1/100 is equivalent to percent or 1%. Therefore, 5/2 is equal to 250%, which is greater than 100%, where the numerator 5 is greater than the base or denominator 2. When a quantity changes from an initial positive amount to another positive amount, for example, price of product that is increased or decreased, one can compute the amount of change as a percent of the initial amount. This is called percent change. If a quantity increases or decreases from A to B, then the base of increase or decrease is the initial amount A. the amount of increase is b minus a, and the amount of decrease will be a minus b, where a is the initial amount and b is the final amount. Here the change equals difference between initial amount and final amount. So the percent change equals percent increase or decrease equals amount of increase or decrease over base times 100%, where 100% denotes 1 and base is the initial amount. So the percent increase equals amount of increase over base times 100% equals the difference between initial amount and final amount over the initial amount times 100%. For example, if a quantity increases from 300 to 375, then the base of increase is the initial amount 300. The base or the initial amount is 300. So the amount increase equals 375 minus 300, where the subtraction results in 75. So the amount of increase is 75. Thus, the percent increase equals 75 over 300 times 100%, which results in 25%, where 7,500 over 300 equals 25. If a quantity doubles in size, then the percent increase is 100%. For example, if a quantity increases from 75 to 150, where 75 times 2 equals 150, because the quantity 75 doubles and it becomes 150, then the percent increase equals the amount of increase, which equals 150 minus 75 is equal to 75, and the base or initial amount is 75. So the percent increase equals 75 over 75 times 100%, which results in 100%. Now the percent decrease equals amount of decrease over base, that is the initial amount, times 100%. For example, if a quantity decreases from 200 to 170, then the base of decrease is the initial amount 200. So the initial amount is 200 and the amount decrease is 200 minus 170, and the subtraction results in 30. Therefore, amount of decrease is 30. So the percent decrease is equal to 30 over 200 times 100%, which results in 15%, where 3000 over 200 results in 15. To change b by a percent of b equals a over 100 times b, because percent is equivalent to 1 over 100. Now, an investment in a mutual fund increased by 15% in a single day. If the value of the investment before the increase was $1,000, what was the value after the increase? Here, 15% of the investment, the initial investment, which was $1,000. So 15% of $1,000 equals 15 over 100 times $1,000, which results in $150. Thus, the value of investment after the change is $1,000 plus $150, and the addition results in $1,150. The final result is the sum of initial investment, 100% of $1,000, and the increase 15% of $1,000. That is, the final result is 100% plus 15%, that is 115% of $1,000, which results in 1150 as well, where 115% equals 115/100, which is the equivalent fraction of the decimal number 1.15. Therefore, 1.15 of $1,000 equals $1,150. Thanks for watching. Perceive, persevere, practice. Do not forget to like, subscribe, and share. Thanking you from Higher Study Prep.